Welcome back, everybody, and welcome to another Halloween edition of our step-by-step tutorials. Today we are going to do a fun little zombie-esque butcher type character. And if you have not gone to jasonseacrest.com, all of the tutorial resources are going to be hanging out. Just fill out the form and I will send you the link to our folder so you can have follow along with us. So let's have some fun. So I'm going to go file new. I'm going to keep it a 5x5 inch. All of our tutorials are pretty much the same format, just so you are aware. We're going to go 5x5 inches. Now, most of my stuff is going to be online or on the web, so I keep my stuff at RGB. But if you are going to have anything printed, then I would recommend moving it over to CMYK. My raster effects is at 300. You might need to click on advanced to see that, and then click on create. Now let's do a little bit of housekeeping first. Under view, double check that your smart guides are in fact turned on. I would also just double check that all of your snaps are turned off. Anytime you're doing kind of a freelance or freehand type drawing, it's just good to have those off. You're going to find that a lot of the time it's going to fight you. Now under general, most of that is going to be good. What I wanted to do is under selection, we are going to be using our pen tool today. So I'm going to recommend having your rubber band turned on. All the little preference that I would recommend for beginners is to have your handles as well as anchors as big as you possibly can. And then also just make sure that your handles and your anchors look a little bit different. So I would recommend that as well. Let's see if there's anything else I would recommend. Under smart guides, I do have mine turned down fairly low in a light gray. You guys might want to turn a whole lot of these off. So if you guys are doing smart guides and you have lines shooting everywhere and it's highly distracting, you don't need those. So you can turn those off. If you're ever aligning or doing something that's really precise, then I would recommend turning those on. But right now, just turn those off. Transformation tools is very handy. And then the one that we really like is to make sure that you have your anchor and path labels turned on. So a lot of the times the tools are going to say, hey, this is where you're at, and it's going to avoid a lot of the beginner frustration if you just kind of wait for it to say anchor and or path. So that's the one for sure I would have turned on. I'm going to click OK. Next little thing, I don't want to sit there and view my artboard. I just think it looks cooler in the video. You do not necessarily need to do that. So let's go to File. I'm going to go Place. This is where you're going to need your anchor point guides. What we are looking for is this little butcher character. And again, we have all this stuff available to you. Just go to jasonseacrest.com again if you want to follow along step by step. Click on Place. Now I am just going to plop it right on down. Now up at the top, I do have Align to Artboard. So I have my center as well as my vertically aligned center. Now if you do not see those, just double check that your icon doesn't look like that. So if it's aligned to selection, you won't see it. All right, I do want to change this. I'm going to click on 5, and that's going to make this fit right into our artboard. Do notice that I do have my little constrained width and proportions selected, so then I'm not crazy or I'm not killing the anchor point guide. Now under layers, we want to make this a template layer. So just go to your menu, upper right-hand corner, and then drop down to where it says template. Just select that. What it's going to do is do 50% opacity. And you're also going to notice that it locks out that layer. So definitely double check that we create a new one. I think I want this one to be teal today. And then I'm going to call this one inking. All right, so before we click off, just notice that that inking layer is selected. I'm going to hide it. Next little thing before we get started is I do want to turn my fill to none. So as we start clicking everything, you're going to notice real fast that if this is selected white, that you're going to start covering up the anchor point guide. So first things first, let's do a little bit of a tear off. I am going to be looking for my pen tool. So look for your pen tool and we want to tear this off. If you're really, really new and you're not planning on doing P and or Shift C for the shortcuts. So I will be doing shortcuts quite a bit, just so you can start to learn them. But if you don't want to do that, just move this as close to what you're working on so you don't have to go all the way back over to your toolbar. So that'll save you a lot of frustration. So before we get started here, don't freak out. We go through everything point by point, every handle. So we will go through all of this together and make your life very, very easy. The beginner mistake is basically looking at all of the points and freaking out. So don't do that. So let's just zoom in on our little face here. And I'm just going to move this over. So I'm not going to be clicking on this, but I will say Shift C. I will say P, and you'll be able to see what tools we're using. We will use some of our shape tools as well. Now, whenever we're doing this, it is going to be a little bit busier today, but that's okay. We'll still have some fun. So I'm going to click on P, and let's just walk through all of these together. It is going to be pretty obvious once we lay them down. So as long as you're following the video, this should be a very easy process. So what we're going to do first is we're just going to do straight lines. And there's really only three tools we're using during this initial process besides the ellipse. We're going to use our pen tool. We are going to be using the anchor point tool. And then we will bounce back and forth between our selection tools. So the white arrow and or black arrow. And I'm just going to simplify our lives by calling them white and black. All right. So let's do a few things. So before we get too carried away. All right. So what we want to do first is if I click on P, this is what our nice process looks like. I am going to click on it. Notice that I am not trying to click directly on the line. I can always come back, click on A and or V to just reset. So if I'm using my pen tool, we're going to do a little bit of troubleshooting right now. I'm just doing nice straight lines. Let's click on that chin. Let's click on that neck. So if you notice that it's still connecting, just click on A, click on V, and then you'll get rid of that rubber band. So the nice part about the rubber band, it's going to let you know that you're still on the pen tool. Next, I'm going to go Shift C. That is our pen tool. Or that's our anchor tool. And all we're going to do is just pull out. Now, if it's going in the wrong direction, just hang on to it and then you can correct it. Now, if you go oops and let go, I'm still on that tool. Just click back on the point and or Control Z. Control Z is your undo. If I want to move my artboard since I'm zoomed in, just use this space bar. That is the hand tool. Now, the hand tool and the zoom are down here. And the reason why they're down here is because you'll never use them. So once you know that the hand tool is your spacebar, and then I can move my artboard, and Z, if you just kind of keep an eyeball on the finger, your left hand should be hanging out on that keyboard over there. All of the heavy hitters are right there in that corner. So you want to just get in the habit, and then we're just going to drag it right on up. We're going to do these eyeballs since there's a little bit of busyness for no reason whatsoever. It's actually going to be very, very easy. So I'm going to draw out our ellipse. I'm just going to be holding down Shift as I do it. Since I have one, I'm going to go Control C, Control F. Control C and Control F is just edit, paste. So if you want to go up to the top and just go edit, paste, you're more than welcome to do so. Back on our circle, I'm just doing our nice little deadpan look. Now I want this to be filled, so I'm going to come in. And if you ever hear me say Shift X, it's just that little toggle. Let's just grab this. I'm going to hold down Alt. Notice that there's that white arrow. That's going to let us know that we are going to duplicate something. I'm going to grab this outside one and then drag it out. So as long as that lines up, you are good. All right, that was easy. I'm still on that circle. I am just going to drag out his ear. Now we're going to use another tool. C is our scissor tool. Scissor tool is usually hanging underneath your eraser tool. Now I'm going to zoom in just so you can see what we are doing. Now if I click on C, notice it'll say path. So I'm looking to make sure that I'm on a path. And since I'm looking to delete kind of this inner part, I want to click twice. Make sure that I'm just clicked on V right there. So the part that I want to delete is now selected. And then I can click on delete. If you need to click it twice, that was it. Let's do that mouth. Let's do that nose. Nose is just a circle, so I'm not going to even hold anything down. I'm just going to draw out a oval. I am on my black arrow, by the way. And we are just going to work on scaling. And I'm going to just kind of move it into place. I'm going to hover on that corner. I am on the white arrow, by the way. So that's just in case you don't want it to be perfectly an oval. Most of the time, I do not. Good, click on C, that is our scissor tool. When it says path, you know you're in the right place. We are basically getting rid of that bottom half. So I'm going to select it with the black arrow and then click on delete. Good. I'm back on my pen tool. And I'm just going to round out the bottom. That was it. We're crushing it. Click on L and or your ellipse tool, and I am just going to draw out a big old circle. I'm not holding down shift or anything. Now I'm on my white arrow, and since this isn't exactly, this is a little bit more off than a perfect oval, but it'll get us there. So I'm just going to line these up, and I'm just moving with my white arrow, by the way. And this tutorial, since especially when we start doing full body characters, a lot of times these anchor point guides will be a little bit bigger. So you can look at the stroke itself and or just eyeball it. Again, it's just a little bit of a helpful guide for you. Click back on P. Now, whenever you're doing the pen tool, good little tidbit is notice that I'm not trying to put that first point on that path. So I'll even zoom in so you can see it. So if I click on P, that's not going to be what I want. So I just, it's going to usually fight me. So I will usually say click a little bit off. Then you can always come on back. And then it won't fight you as much. So a good little thing if you're noticing that it's just connecting too much. Then just kind of click off a little bit. Again, I'm back on the pen tool. You kind of get the process at this point. I'm going to click on A. So whenever you see that the handles aren't exactly the same, usually we are going to keep a nice smooth curve. We're going to bounce over to the white arrow. If you go Shift C and you come over without switching to A, you're going to notice that it's going to break that corner or that smooth curve, and it's going to get a little bit choppy on you. So just pay attention to if you ever see kind of a handle floating, switch over, and then you're good. Nice straight lines first, just plopping on over there. And again, I'm just looking at that stroke. That was it. Control minus to zoom out. I am using my space bar. Let's click on L. That is our ellipse. And I am holding down shift. And I am holding down alt option. So it'll be your alt key if you have a Windows. It'll be an option key if you have a Mac. So I'm going to zoom in again, and we are looking to do our scissor tool, so C. So notice I'm just on the outside, especially as notice that we're very zoomed in. The tendency is, if you're zoomed out, that sometimes you think you're close and you're actually just selecting the wrong line. If you get really zoomed in, it's actually really, really easy to see. And then I will probably say 100% of the time, we are always getting rid of something. So you always want to just double check that you create two points, one and then one at the top, and then click delete. All right, let's do this hand, and maybe we'll do that little hatchet, and then all of that was the hard part. Everything else will be super easy from here on out. So again, we're just doing the same process. We're starting with those straight lines. pretty much every time to reset, I'm clicking Shift C, by the way, since I already know I've got to do my handles. Click back on P. So notice that when it's getting closer, you might be able to see that cursor is trying to do things. So it's actually trying to delete points, so that is why we just try and not avoid clicking directly on that path. If I'm going too fast, again, just drag this thing over. You can always pause. No harm in pausing. I will never know. Let's put it that way. Good. Shift C. Now we are doing all of the handles with the... This is all going to get deleted, so I'll just leave it right there. You're going to notice that I am doing the anchor tool, but if you wanted to do A, and then if you wanted to come back in, so let's just go Shift C. Some of you might have our curvature tool. Just drag the point out a little bit farther. So this is the CC people, and then I could always drag it in. So if you like that option, feel free. Usually the anchor point guides aren't for the curvature tool. Not everyone has CC yet. I'm going to click on this guy here. Now, there's a little thing to point out is just look at the icon. I can just grab the stroke itself. So why I point that out is if you're missing, especially as you're trying to grab that anchor, just be aware that if I am able with the anchor tool to grab that path. So if it's bouncing all over the place and you're having a lot of frustration, just be aware that I can grab that stroke and then you can avoid it. Shift C. Notice then that when I was with the pen tool, since I'm really zoomed in, I'm just using this space bar and then I can move it. Other little option, especially if you see only two, you can always do your segment. I'm doing Shift C again. And then you can just place it with your tool. So since there's only two points, that is an option. This is where you guys go, what? We didn't have to use it that whole time. Most of these strokes, I'll give you a little bit of a insider's guide here. Most of these are going to be already designed for what the brush thicknesses are going to be. And so that's why they are actually not all just two line segments and things like that. So just pay attention to that. And it is one of the tools you're going to want to learn anyway. So reasoning behind everything, right? I'm just going to grab those lines. I'm not too concerned if the handles line up or not. Just rounding it out. Good enough. Let's do some circles. I'm going to click on L, but you can just go and click on the ellipse tool. Now, anytime you see them perfectly nice and circular, just know that I'm going to be holding down Shift as well as the Alt option. I'm actually going to drag that out so we can get that corner. I'm still on my ellipse tool. All right, that looks good. Let's do this one right here. Now I'm going to go Shift C, and I'm just going to click this one little top corner. Right now we'll leave that. We might modify it later. Control 0. Let's go File, Save. Save it to where you want. Recording. Good. I'm going to hit OK. All right, let's do some easy ones. So again, I'm still on the pen tool. We're just playing connect the dots. Now I'm gonna drag this one out, and just some things to pay attention to. I can just come over here, just click on that handle and it'll snap back. So now I got a nice sharp curve. Just seeing where I want things. Let's go all the way around. I'm gonna zoom in on this arm. We'll do a cuff. Now I think I can just stop right there because the other one's gonna be part of the hand. So I'm gonna go back to my tool, my anchor tool. We're just gonna smooth these guys out. Notice I'm on my white arrow, by the way. I'm okay with that. Keep your lives easy today. Bottom of the hand, knuckle. We're gonna do right there, and we'll bring it on back. And I will zoom in so you can see. There's that one. So notice that this one's a little bit sharper. So those aren't going in the same direction anymore. Same thing with the hand. So I might notice I was on the anchor tool, and then I'll keep my sharp edge. Shift C, let's just grab that curve. And all we're doing is just rounding out this fingertip. Most of this is just going to be hidden by the palm, by the way. That's totally going to get deleted. I'm going to take this edge. I'm just going to bring that out. Control 0. All right, let's do some legs. These will be the easiest legs we've ever done. Click on P again. Back up, Shift C. Let's just grab those curves and just line it up. Now, if you need to zoom in, feel free. I want that to be a little bit curved. Good, and I'm going to click on P. I'm going to hold down Shift as I drop down. I want this one to be a little bit straight. Belly, and I think this one's going to go right up by his face. And I'm just grabbing those paths, and I'm just dragging it down. If you want to be concerned about exactly where that is, feel free, but we are not going to worry about it. That second one, we're really not going to worry about. This first one is going to basically, we are looking to define the belly a little bit. So that is what we are doing. All right, I'm going to do this neck, and then everything else is pretty well a circle. So I'm going to start down here. I'm actually aligning it with this right point. Notice I'm back on A, by the way. So notice that whenever they're not equal, that it is going to be bouncing to the white arrow. I'm going to go right there, and this one's going to go right on back up. So notice it's trying to connect. That's why I'm just going to move it off just so it doesn't try to connect. And I can just take my white arrow and then just move those anchors into place. Okay, so I want that one, Shift C. I'm just going to click on that, and that's going to sharpen up a little bit. Now I'm going to grab our rounded rectangle. Draw another one. And all I really want, I'm actually going to flip it a little bit from the original, is I just want kind of this back or the bottom part of it. So just kind of this little part. Just on the bottom. So all this top part will get deleted. Back to the ellipse. I'm going to shift X. Now whenever you're moving things, especially circles, I just find that it's a little bit easier when you fill them before you move them. Otherwise it really likes to rotate them. Let's go over here. Good. We're just going to draw three little segments. Let's grab our little line. Two. Three. They're not coloring because they are on. Good. Shift X. Let's just color it. Needs a stroke. That's what's happening. Now I'm going to go Shift C and I'm just going to drag these down. Let's just shove that one right in the middle. I am okay with that. Control 0. Let's do a little bit of blood splatter. And then we are all done. So I am just pulling out some ovals. I'm not holding anything down. I'm on my black arrow, by the way. This one looks a little bit more perfect. This one's actually got two little guys. So I'm just using my arrows. Shift C. Again, we're going to get a little teardrop. Control 0. I think we did it. I'm just doing a little bit of a boogie check. Make sure all of our lines are in there. All right, looks good. I'm going to go file save. Let's do a digital high five right here, because this one was a tricky one. There might be one little one that we missed in the armpit. So I'm going to grab that right there. So I'm going to zoom in. Good. Control 0. Now I'm going to go over into our layers, and I definitely want to duplicate this one out. You will notice that we duplicate quite a bit, and that's just so we can always go back. We don't have to worry about things. So as we keep adding new things on, I always like having it. So in case I go, oops, and or, hey, I want to change the design a little bit, I have all of these that are still in stroke form. So what we're going to do with this one is just double click it. We want this one to start adding on our brushes. Notice that these are hidden and locked out, and I'm on that top layer before I click off of that. Now I do, looks like I already have mine, but let's just show you how to get our tinted brushes. If you find the brush menu, just select it. At the bottom left-hand corner, you will see brush libraries, and you're going to drop down to where it says other library. And depending, usually it's going to try and do default. What you are looking for is you are going to be looking for our brush files. So double click, and this would be what your file would look like. So more than likely it's in downloads or something like that. And you are looking at your cartoon brushes. So again, we are going to be doing cartoon brushes. All of these, just so everyone is aware, especially when you're in Dropbox, is these are all of our libraries. The only one that is not a brush library is this old file that says how to install cartoon brushes that goes along with a 3-year-old video. So if you were ever looking to adjust the size of your brushes, or if you find that you're using a different file size, then you might want to follow along to that older video. All right, let's have some fun. I am done with that. We are definitely done with this one, so just get rid of it. And we are going to zoom in. And very quickly, brushes 101. Anytime you see edges or the lines or the kind of those ends that are floating out in space, Those are going to be the ones that are going to be tapered on both ends. Now, some of them are going to be tapered floating out in space, but one of those edges might actually be touching something. So if you click it, and if it says, hey, it's going in the wrong direction, so notice that that's the end I want to be tapered, you're going to notice that we have brushes that have multiple different directions on it, and that will solve that. So typically, you just click on one, and you'll be able to tell pretty quickly if it's going in the wrong direction. Now, as we are doing this, things we are peeking for is we don't want short lines. So I always want that to hide those ends. And we always want to go past. That looks good. So what I would be looking for is to see if that corner on the head is popping through. Sometimes it's not as big of a deal, especially when you start to add on the thickness of the brushes. Let's do two. Most of these I think are going to be two. For these, I want all of these to go fat on both ends. That could go fat on both ends. Same thing here. And take that back. I want this one to go fat down by the armpit. And for right now, just so everyone's got a little bit of a method behind the madness, I am going to just try and get all of the lines down. Then we are going to adjust how fat everything is. So I'm kind of just clicking it right now, just so we can see if we need to adjust anything. Let's go fat on both ends. So this is a good example. So notice that that edge, I'll zoom in so you can see that we got a big fat part that's sticking out there. So as long as it's hiding, all of that is just going to get tucked in to our, within the line itself. I'm going to drop that down to 0.5. We are just going around and saying, what is touching? If it's touching, that should go fat. Right shot side should be fat. I might want to just adjust that. Let's pop that up to 2. Okay, I'm black arrow, by the way, shift X, and we are just going to start to grab our circles here, shift X, and that's just, all that's doing is swapping out the fill. Since we have a black stroke, it'll just color it black, and let's zoom in over here. I want the fat to go and hide within that circle. That looks good, and you're going to notice that it is tinted, by the way, so don't get freaked out. We are fully aware that we're going to need to fix that. If I ever need to adjust things, you can select them with the white arrow. So I'm just selecting these 2 points and I can adjust them. Oh, let's go fat on both ends. I'm going to bump that up to, let's go 4. He's going to have some pretty fat lines going around. Oh, I'm going to keep this one basic. So up at the top, if I ever want to switch it just back to basic, just click on it. So not every single thing has to have a stroke on it. I'm going to click on this one, and I think we can just zoom in on that hand because we are almost done. I want this one to be skinny on both. Same thing here. Both of these are going to be fat on both ends. I'm going to bump it up to 2. So notice I'm on white arrow, and I'm just using my arrow keys to kind of extend those out. Doing shift X, same thing here, shift X. I might add a bulge to those later, but right now we're going to keep it on those drops. This is all going to get filled in black, so I'm not too concerned. Same thing with under the eyeballs. Let me just zoom in on the ear. So I'm going to take that point and just extend it out. So I want to take this and let's extend. These two are all going to get hidden into this line, so that's why I want to make sure that that all gets hidden. All right, guys, I think we are good to go. So all we are doing before we do this next step is we are just zooming in, and we just want to make sure that all of those edges look like they're hidden. We will more than likely miss one. Not a big deal if we do. All right, good. I'm gonna go Control Zero. Let's go File, Save. We are now done with our brushes. Let's actually take this. Let's go 2 with it. I'm gonna go Shift X with that handle too. Now with this brushes, I definitely want, this is the one I always say is the most important one, since we just spent a whole bunch of time working to get to this point. So we wanna definitely make sure that we keep it. So we wanna basically say brushes, and this is gonna be the one that we are going to expand. But before we do, just any little last thing that you think, hey, I want to adjust this. So this is the last point before all of our strokes disappear. And this is definitely where we are gonna start to clean up all of these edges. I know it's been bothering you guys. But anything that you think, hey, I want this to be a little bit fatter, this is a good time to do so. All right, so I'm going to take this little circle all the way over here. Just grab it. We are basically going to go expand appearance. That's going to basically expand our brushes. Next, we're going to go object, expand. And then anything that was still a stroke, basically that is what is going to expand. And we are ready for the next step. So just double check that that pop-up did show up. That is usually where most people get hung up. And this is how easy this process is. So we have all sorts of weird overlapping. And that is so we don't have to adjust every one of these. Now my recommendation, let's see if we can zoom in close enough where you can see it, is once you kind of see where a line is, you can always zoom in. I will say it is much easier when you zoom in. If you want to adjust your eraser. So we are on the eraser night right now. So let me just, I'm just kind of showing you and then we'll actually explain it. So if I select black arrow, I'm gonna go Shift E and or your eraser tool. And then I just get rid of the overlap. So I select on the shape, Shift E. If I want to adjust that brush size, my bracket keys are next to the P key, especially for finer lines. But anything that looks off, that is basically what we are now getting rid of. And some people usually say, why do we do that? Is to line up these edges perfectly is a giant, it is not fun. So it is actually easier just to kind of hide them within each other. And then you can actually control the brushes a lot easier than trying to align them up. And there are other different ways of doing line variation. Just I find that brushes is way, way faster. Good. We're just looking for anything that's, so pretty much anything inside that ear, we already know is going to get erased. I'm gonna get rid of that. And then anything past. That shoulder is what we're gonna get rid of. Let's zoom in and do the hand. Now I'm kinda doing this blind. Shift E. I'm gonna zoom out since we have all sorts of fun overlapping in that hand. I think that should do just fine. All right, so I'm gonna grab that thumb first, or this pinky here. I want that handle to go popping out on that side of the pinky, and then I just need to come back through and find my thumb. So I'm just going bit by bit until I find where my line is, by the way. Now that I can see it, we can get rid of that. Good. Get rid of those little extras. Let's just do a save check. We've been working hard. Now let's do these last little bits and I think we're it. We've got our hand, our leg done. Just remember, I'm selecting the shape, so whichever parts you want first. Since we got quite a bit, I'm gonna adjust. Did I miss it? Oh, I totally knew it. I knew it. All right, all we're doing is a last little second boogie check here. All right, that looks good. So I'm gonna take brush expanded. I am okay if this is all on the same layer. I'm gonna basically grab all of our black. And you're probably gonna have to do it twice depending on if your tolerance is low. So my magic wand tolerance is down at 5. And so I have a tinted line, and then we have our black lines. So what I am gonna do is I'm gonna find Pathfinder. If you don't have Pathfinder, it should be up under Window. Just drop down until you see Pathfinder. And then we are going to unite all of our black. I'm gonna go Control-Zero, And we're going to actually just fill in a few things here. I'm going to go Object, Live Paint, and then Make. Now I'm just going to go black, arrow, just click off of it. If I click on K, that is going to be our Live Paint. And then I'm just filling in some spots right now that I think are going to be just filled in. Just seeing if I missed anything. That looks good for right now. The next video is going to be all about us filling in the color. So I'm going to click on Expand. I only really want Object. And we're going to basically unite it again. Let's just do all of our blacks for a night. If you're not super confident, you don't necessarily have to do this step. But I'm just going to click on Unite. And everything that we just filled in, it's going to be all nice together. So I'm going to go File, Save. And that is going to be the end of our inking one. Now this one was a little bit trickier. I'm not going to lie to you. So if you made it, let's do a little digital high five. You made it. And on the next component is going to be all of the coloring. The coloring is usually 10 times easier than the inking. Whenever we do the full body ones, if you made it all the way through, definitely make sure that you say, hey, I'm doing these full body ones. I'm liking them. And or if you are struggling with anything, definitely just let me know. And then I usually am able to get back in touch with you. I would say same day and or 24 hours. It just depends on when I see the comments and the notification that someone made a comment. So other than that, I will see you guys on the next video, which will be the coloring of our little butcher character.